ओके सो वेलकम टू 12th ऑनलाइन इंफॉर्मेटिव सेशन योगा वेट स्ट्रेंथ रिलीज फॉर टीचर्स। सो योगा इज इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर ऑल, इट्स नॉट फॉर टीचर, इट्स इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर ऑल एंड दैट इज व्हाई वी हैव चोजन दिस टॉपिक अंडर आवर लेक्चर सीरीज, दैट इज दत्तोपंत लेक्चर सीरीज। एंड अगेन वी हैव द इमिनेंट स्पीकर सुबोध तिवारी, ही इज द सीईओ कैवल्य धाम योगा इंस्टीट्यूट। फॉर फॉर्मल इंट्रोडक्शन आई रिक्वेस्ट सुभाष आठवले सर, प्लीज इंट्रोड्यूस आवर टुडे स्पीकर।
He
हेलो
is
सर, प्लीज
well known
इंट्रोड्यूस।
to me.
अटोले सर, कैन यू हियर मी? ओके, नो प्रॉब्लम।
सुबह सर,
हेलो,
हाँ सुबह
यस
सर,
आर
बोल
बोथ
रहा
यू
था मैं।
देयर?
ओके, नो प्रॉब्लम, आई विल इंट्रोड्यूस द टुडे स्पीकर। तो और टुडे स्पीकर इज श्री सुबोध तिवारी, इज वेरी वेल नोन पर्सनैलिटी। ही इज द सीईओ ऑफ कैवल्य धाम योगा इंस्टीट्यूट एट लोनावला। श्री तिवारी सर वॉज बॉर्न इन योगा एटमोस्फेरिक एट कैवल्य धाम लोनावला। एट वेरी यंग एज ही रिसीव्ड स्पिरिचुअल इनिशिएशन फ्रॉम स्वामी दिगंबर जी, हु इज द डायरेक्टर एंड स्पिरिचुअल हेड ऑफ कैवल्य धाम योगा इंस्टीट्यूट। He is also Vice President of Indian Yoga Association, New Delhi. He is also a board member of Academic Committee, Ministry of Ayush, Government of India. He is also a board of member of Council of Yoga Accreditation International for 2 years. So we have such eminent personality for the today's session. श्री तिवारी सर, प्लीज स्टार्ट योर सेशन।
Namaskar to all of you, and I am very happy to be amongst you virtually, which we have been doing for last almost 40 days. So our physical distancing probably is increasing, but digital closeness is increasing. We have a topic of yoga and stress management in specific reference to teachers, because you all are this huge group of educators, educator administrators involved in various aspect dimensions of education. I will take you through a presentation and discussion in next 45 minutes. And the first step we will डिस्कस अबाउट सम फंडामेंटल कॉन्सेप्ट्स ऑफ योग, योग के कुछ मूल तत्व, बिकॉज योग टुडे इज ऑल्सो लाइक ब्लाइंड, सिक्स ब्लाइंड मैन एंड एलिफेंट, बिकॉज वेन यू से योग मेनी पीपल अंडरस्टैंड वेरियस अदर परस्पेक्टिव, सो लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड दैट. एंड आई कम फ्रॉम कैवल्य धाम, विच इज ए साइंटिफिक रिसर्च इंस्टीट्यूशन. So we will look at the scientific evidence of how yoga has been able to deal with various dimensions of human personality. So without wasting more time, I would share my screen and my presentation with you so that we are on the same page. And if there is a we will have question and answer sessions later where we will definitely be able to. So I hope you can see the screen right now. And So I come from Kavaladham, and we say where yoga tradition and science meet, because the important role of analysis of yoga from the source is done here. Jitne bhi purani pandulipiyan hain, the manuscripts of yoga are analyzed, and we look at critical editions and then come out with as a source material on which research hypothesis is based. So we have been there since 1924, and going further, this is our founder, Swami Kuvalanandaji, who founded the Kavaladham Yoga Institution. And he was succeeded by Swami Digambarji, who was my spiritual guru and teacher. And under their guidance, we have grown. It was in the year 1917, what we say is the era of modern renaissance of yoga, where Swamiji started his work while he was in Baroda. At that time, it was, the Mumbai Presidency, Bombay Presidency. He established Kavaladham Lonavala in 24. And this is where, for the first time, scientific research in yoga started in modern times. As academicians who are also researchers, it would be of interest that it was the first time where yoga was put into the laboratory, clinical analysis. So we all know asan bahut mahatvapurna hai, pranayam bahut mahatvapurna hai, but wo karne se humko kya hota hai at various levels. That is what was taken ahead by Swamiji. He said we cannot make a single statement without having scientific evidence to support it. So that was the specialty of this great man who started the renaissance of the yoga in modern times. And every one of you who is interested in reading about the history should get one book, which is called The Science of Yoga, The Risks and Rewards, written by William Broad. He is a scientific reporter in the New York Times, a very well-researched book for everyone to understand the history of yoga in the modern times. And it will be of great benefit to all of us. Kavaladham was the first institution in 1962, which was declared as an institute for higher education in yoga by the Ministry of Education then. So that was the contribution of Kavaladham since long decades. I'll just slide through some slides to give you idea of the institution before we touch on our topic. Mahatma Gandhiji, of course, a student of Swami Kuvalanandaji, a very ardent practitioner, the founder of the Banaras Hindu University. You see the Prime Minister of India then, the Dalai Lama, Dr. H.V. Kamath, and these are various people who took interest in yoga at that time. And lastly, the importance of the yoga research, which was highlighted in a discussion between Dr. B.R. Ambedkarji and H.V. Kamath, speaking of the scientific rationale of yoga, which was already being researched in 1949 by Swami Kuvalanandaji. Why? As to the interest of the political will at that point of time to support the research in yoga. Now let's get into our topic. So we are to speak and we are to listen and we are to learn of yoga and its role as into stress management. And before we do that, let's understand something which are very fundamental to us as human beings. We have a cycle in life which all of us are aware of. I say everyone, you are born and then some kind of formal or informal education is got by everyone. Of course, you work in some, you may be a person who's serving, who you may be business, you get into that routine and you grow up and you continue to do things, grow old until you do bye-bye to this world. And this is mostly everyone goes through these, cycles in life. Now, somewhere down the line, when we look at the areas where we say, oh, we are stressed or we have anxiety or if we are not harmonious as we should be, normally the self has three dimensions. ये हमको समझना पड़ेगा. अगर व्यक्ति आज में रहे, if all of us live in today, then the amount of stress or anxiety will be far less. But what happens mostly, सबसे ज्यादा हम लोगों ने देखा है, that either we live in times where we relive past, where there are too many regrets. ऐसा नहीं होना चाहिए था, ये गलत हो गया, and probably this is not the way it should be. And that regret causes that mixed emotions, which results in mixed mental health. Or one may have future anxiety, like probably many of us in today's time. After 40 days at home, what do we do? The new normal, what it would be? When do we return? When would it resume? And every time we have a date where lockdown ends, is supposed to end, we have apprehension that, oh, it might go further for a week or two. So future anxiety we live in. And that, what that happens is, it is a double-edged sword, because not only will you be anxious when the lockdown increases, you are actually anxious now. Okay, so if we have a lockdown, say till 17, the very thought that, oh, it will increase more than 17 will further cause anxiety to us as human beings. Because for 17 days, we will be worried ki 17 tarikh ko kya hone wala hai aur badhne wala hai. The anxiety about future increases the stress of present day. What is the concept of yoga? Because like I said, Kevaladham is one of the oldest institutions in the world. Yoga, as understood, essentially comes from the Yoga Sutras written by Maharishi Patanjali. So everyone should understand, as someone who wants to understand yoga, that if you want to say who is the founding father of yoga as practiced today's form, it is Maharishi Patanjali. Because that is where we find a complete science of yoga called the Patanjali's Yoga Sutras. So all of us should know this thing very clearly. Foundation of yoga is seen in the Patanjali Yoga Sutras. Patanjali Maharishi, when did he visit this planet Earth? Around 500 BC. So it's around 2500 years old, but still very relevant. And that is the source, that is the original source of knowledge of yoga. There are four chapters, 195 sutras. And what does yoga, Patanjali Yoga Sutra say? Its foundation is, there is an element of the philosophical foundation. Here, hetu, hana, hanupaya. So what does it mean? Dukkha. There is this disharmony, what we may say as anxiety, what we may say as stress, what we may say as misery. Very simple. Every human being goes through it. There is cause for that dukkha. So dukkha, we should understand from broader perspective. And he says there are five rooted causes in human beings. थोड़ा हम ध्यान देके अगर समझे तो बहुत आनंद आएगा. वो पांच चीजें क्या हैं? What are those five things? Five kleshas: avidya, asmita, raag, dvesh, abhinivesh. We are born with it. So friends, let us understand. Ignorance is avidya, not being aware. You're born, and that non-awareness leads to disharmony. Asumita, too much of ego, too much of I-ness. Rag, attachment, too much of attachment with anything is going to cause you misery. Dvesha bhava, the negativity, the tamasic pravritti, which if it increases beyond a certain point is going to cause disharmony. and Abhinivesh. Now, this concept has been used for those of you who are from the field of psychology. Jung has used it extensively. Freud has used it extensively, this concept of fear of death. And Patanjali right then had said that these five kleshas are the root cause of the dukkha. So one has to make an effort to reduce, to control these five fundamental elements. So these are the cause. There is a question, can it be tackled? Yes, it can be tackled. How can it be tackled? It can be tackled by practices of Ashtanga Yoga. So I hope you are with me till now. And I hope you are not more confused than what you were earlier. So, very simple concepts. And why I am saying these are fundamental concepts? Because now when we look at the scene of yoga today, our perception is very different. We only think of asanas. Probably we think, oh, yoga means only doing postures. Whereas that is not the truth. Asanas is just 1/8 of the part of yoga. A very small part of yoga. Now, having understood this concept of principally by Patanjali, let's see what are the 8 limbs of yoga, what we say Ashtanga Yoga. Now remember, friends, as I have said, that the perception of a yoga as only asanas is not true. There are 5 dimensions of yoga, I say. And you have to understand that there is yoga which is traditional from the source, which I say scientific and traditional. And there is this newer kind of yoga, and all of us should understand this because we live in today's world, we are all teachers and we need to be educated, most of us would be, but just rehearse what has been the point of confusion. Yoga, which has been founded in the source of tradition, texts and modern science, is defined as a process for well-being of your physical, mental, emotional, social, and spiritual well-being. 5 dimensions. I will repeat. Physical, mental, emotional, social, and spiritual dimension. This is the traditional aspect of yoga. The modern yoga, what you see, you must have seen posters of hot yoga, power yoga, reverse yoga, aquatic yoga. These are all modern kinds of yoga whose total approach is confined, it is only consistent with physical. So one distinction we should understand. The contemporary trends of yoga essentially deal with only physical. So when we say there are 5 dimensions of the traditional and the scientific aspect, what are those dimensions and how is Ashtanga Yoga relevant? Because Patanjali says that you can deal with the issues of stress, anxiety, disharmony through practice of Ashtanga Yoga. So if you understand Ashtanga Yoga, at least philosophically, you can easily understand what is Ashtanga Yoga and how does it impact. Patanjali says, 2 aspects are very important, and that is how you are in your characteristic. Yama and Niyama are those aspects of your interpersonal and intrapersonal relationship. Yamas is interpersonal. How am I to behave with another human being? Essentially, like I would like the other human being to behave with me. And if these characteristics are maintained, then I would be in a happier zone. I would be in a more harmonious zone. So what does he say? Ahimsa, Satya, Asteya, Brahmacharya, Parigraha. These are 5 yamas, which if we try to follow at our mental level, at our behavioral level, we will be more in harmony. But what happens, friends, when we say yoga, we straight away jump to asanas. No one wants to deal with the mind aspect. And for example, How does ahimsa work? Suppose you are going to college and you have, upon arrival, you have a first lecture in the college. Somehow there is a traffic jam and someone has blocked the road. Suddenly the anger inside you, because anger is mental violence, the anger arises, you are frustrated, you must have said 5 bad things to that person who has blocked the road for reasons which neither you know, and then you reach college for your first lecture. Now you have a bunch of students coming there, and one student somehow is not observant to the discipline. In normal days, you would have politely told him, XYZ, please sit properly, please take your place, let us start. But that day you are disturbed. So you would have this anger pour out and you will probably shout at that student. You are agitated and that agitation passes on to that student. So what happens is it starts from our own non-ability to control and leads further to another person, which might lead to another person. So these are those aspects of personality, if we work through practice, will be the foundation of your harmony. And a harmonious person naturally has the ability to be dealing with stress in a better way. Niyamas. Niyamas are how I deal with myself. Intrapersonal. Saut santosh tapas swadhyay ishwar pranidhan. Cleanliness, are we speaking of only mind or only body? No, we are speaking of a holistic component. These are something which we have to do for our own self. And therefore, we have to remember these are continuous practices. Gyan sabko hai, information sabko hai, wisdom sabko hai. लेकिन ये फंडामेंटल चीजों का पालन करने की क्षमता बहुत कम लोगों में है. इसलिए पतंजलि कहते हैं कि प्लीज स्टार्ट विद दिस, इट्स एन एवरीडे अफेयर एंड देयरफॉर दिस इज द फाउंडेशन ऑफ योगा. एंड देन कम्स द थर्ड अंग विच इज द आसनास. आसन मींस स्थिर सुखम आसनम. सो पतंजलि डिफाइन्स आसन. वॉट वी नो इज द मोस्ट पॉपुलर एस्पेक्ट ऑफ योग. एंड वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड फ्रेंड्स दैट दिस इज वेयर इट स्टार्ट्स एज टू स्टेबिलिटी ऑफ योर बॉडी. सो प्लीज remember, asanas is about being stable at your physical level and which will take you to steadiness at your mental level. So that is what is important. Asana is not about acrobatics. Asana is not about how difficult it can be. 3 sutras you should remember. Sthir sukham asanam. What is asana? Something which is sthir, which is steady. Sukha, it gives you a feeling of blissfulness. It's not that if I'm trying to make you bend, then I sit on your back and push you. No, that is not asana, because that will cause you dukkha. That will become sthir dukkham asana. No, there should be no. It's about sukha, sthir sukha. Prayatna shaithilya ananta samapati vyaya. What effortlessness. You should be effortless because there should be no force of any kind. It is stability is more important, remember friends. And therefore, it has to be effortless. And what is the result of asana? Tato dvandh anabhigata is taken away. So friends, asanas are something which from your physical stability leads you to mental stability. So we need to take it in that spirit. Otherwise, nowadays we have a lot of competition in ourselves. So that is something which we have to be very careful about. And now some scientific evidence about this. Okay. Now let's see. We say sthir sukham asanam. What does it mean? It means steadiness. So what did we do? Swamiji said, and later we studied that what happens. Suppose you do asanas like exercise. So you see this A. All A graph is when asanas were done in a form of exercise with lot of tension, lot of exercise mode. What happens? The EMG study, you can see yourself are very distorted. There is heaviness in the activity of your muscles. But when the practitioner was asked to do asanas as we have recommended, sthir sukham, blissfully you do asanas. How was it? It was done in a way where you see these as the readings of the graph, where you have very, very subtle readings which are coming in. So how it is to be done? In a sthirata, in a way which is balanced. And that is the evidence which we have got. Second aspect is pranayama. All of us know pranayama has become very popular. Pranayama ka abhyas kyun important hai? Because breath is something which connects you to this universe every second. हर क्षण हम लोग श्वास प्रश्वास से इस स्वर्ग इस धरती से कनेक्टेड है. सो आवर ऋषिज थॉट दैट ब्रेथ हैज डायरेक्ट रिलेशनशिप विद द एक्टिविटी ऑफ योर माइंड चित्त. हट प्रदीपिका. हट प्रदीपिका इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टेक्स्ट एंड हट प्रदीपिका हैज वन श्लोक. इट सेज चले वाते चले चित्तम निश्चलम चलम भवे योग स्थानुर्वापि नोति तथो वायु निरोध. सो इट सेज दैट द ब्रेथ इज डायरेक्टली रिलेटेड टू योर एक्टिविटी ऑफ द चित्त. दैट मीन्स दैट इफ यू कंट्रोल योर ब्रेथ यू कैन कंट्रोल योर माइंड. सो फ्रेंड्स, this was not only a hypothesis in a text which is 2000 or it is 800 years old, but we also researched, and when we researched we found that it is actually true that when you are able to control your breath you are able to control. And where does this stress come from? Aapke man mein sabse zyada pareshani kya hoti jab aapka man chanchal hai. When you are unable to control your mind, that is the root cause of anxiety. So if you are able to control your mind, you are able to control the activity of your chitta, and there you can control the anxiety which is coming to you. This has been proved by so many experiments, some of which I will be telling you here. This was one of the first experiments which Swamiji did. This was on Udhyana Bandha. Udhyana Bandha is a cleansing process which comes before the practices of pranayama. This practice, as you see, proved that it generates negative pressure in your visarya. And what does negative pressure do? Improves the blood circulation in your vital functional organs. It increases your peristaltic movements. It enhances your digestive capabilities. Not digestion, but digestive capabilities. So, practices like these are very potent. Or this is the essence of yoga. Because this is how you should understand the foundation of practices is there. And you see these negative pressure which Swamiji named after his guru, which is called Madhav Das Vacuum. It was a historical finding in scientific world of yoga. So this is related to pranayama.
It's
lot of work with breath. Now this is a very interesting study. I'll devote 2 minutes to it, because hum sabhi log jante hain ki kuch cheez kaam karti hai, but kaise kaam karti hai iska humko purava chahiye, iska humko evidence chahiye. ये हमारे यहाँ एक व्यक्ति आया था. देयर वाज वन मैन हु वाज अ फुटबॉल फैन, ब्राजील का था, वर्ल्ड कप मैच था. So our researchers got him and they said, we will show you the match, but we want you to do something for us. Razi ho gaya. What should I do? So they said, you drink this barium. We want to do some experiments. He said, all right. So they made him drink barium, and this was 1980s. So what happens is black and white TV thing. So he got this done and they took an X-ray that time. So this photo is after normal stomach, after barium meal. And after 10 minutes, you see this exactly rounded off, muscles are, you know, visible. This is a normal stomach. Then our researchers informed him, Baba, abhi we cannot show you the football match because TV kharab ho gaya. So suddenly there was anxiety, there was anger, there was so much of anger. This experiment we tried to prove what happens when you are angry. So this man got angry and he was furious that you made false promises. Asa challa nahi, asa tumhi kaise karu shakta? And then the researchers held on to him and they tried to take another X-ray, which you see here. And this X-ray shows the irritation of the muscular lining, the soft lining of the stomach. And this is how it appears when you have actually got ulcer or bad, health issues related to your stomach. He was then told, Baba, after 5 minutes, we will start the football match for you. Don't worry. Just relax. Do Shavasana for 5 minutes. And 5 minutes later, they took, see the difference between the X-ray. That time, X-ray was available. And therefore, suddenly everything was normalizing, more relaxed. Digestion would have improved. Everything would have improved. If now, because of stress, friends, your mind affects your vital organs. And when your mind affects the vital organs, this is the state where you live most of the time. We don't realize. And then suddenly you start hearing stories that, are, wo to sirf 50 saal ka tha, usko ye problem ho gaya, ye attack aa gaya, wo aa gaya. This is a result of consistent presence of mind stressors which affects your body. So this is an evidence which was generated, and thereafter a lot of work has happened on the aspect of effect of mind on mind of pranayama and practice. So we have done yama, niyama, asana, pranayama. Now the fifth is pratyahara. Very important. Pratyahara is your ability not to be affected. So all of us are in teaching field. And sometimes what happens, sometimes you go to college or school and you enter the principal's cabin. Principal, if he is married, may not have had a good morning. He is angry, frustrated. He sees you, you walk in first thing in the morning to his cabin. And he wants to find some fault. He finds some fault and he shouts. Now, you think, Baba, isme meri kya galti thi? Main to wish karne gaya tha subah. Abhi, usne to chilla diya. To wo teacher wahan se professor jata hai and he goes to the classroom and first student he finds, he blasts him. Student bolta hai, meri kya galti thi? Main to bechara professor ko wish karne wala tha. And this sequence may continue because each one of us is getting emotionally and psychologically affected by others' behavior, which is not in our control. Pratyahara says, if you develop an ability to be unaffected at your own will, which comes by practices of yama, niyama, asana, pranayama, then your state of harmony, which in modern terms, your stress management will be beautiful. Unaffected at your own will. So same person walking into principal's cabin realizes the principal or the person or the boss is not in best of his mood, he leaves what has been told to him right in the office itself, does not walk out because he has the ability not to be affected. He does not carry further the anger. What happens? There is harmony. There is more equanimity in everyone. And that is what you should derive by the practices of Yama, Niyama, Asana, Pranayama. And this is true for everyone. Everyone has the ability to reach there with practices. So when you practice Yama, Niyama, Asana, Pranayama, the ability of Pratyahar, the example is Kachua. Kasavasto, the tortoise, when someone tries to harm, head under leta hai, charo limbs under leta hai, he's blissful, nothing impacts him. That is the state of pratyahara. Now dharana, this is important. So little attention, this is probably our last 10 minutes. So friends, dharana is your ability to concentrate. What happens in today's world, and more so with the teaching fraternity must be knowing about this recent study, the span attention of our students is reducing. Earlier we used to say 45 minutes lecture is ideal because that is the time for cognition. But now, in a study which I read, they said that actual straight cognition time of a youngster today is only 2 minutes. Unless you change the cognition of that student, the impetus to the cognition, his thoughts will stray away. So therefore, ability to concentrate for each individual will result in the health of his mind and his ability of keeping thoughts together. Concentration is through various practices, but the result of concentration is your ability to be ekagra. Every human being should have this ability. Wo kehte hain, bheed mein bhi hum akele the. The ability to be yourself in amidst chaos. Today is the testing time for each one of us. Those of you who can be calm, quiet and concentrated. How much can one do at this time? So if you are able to concentrate on something good, your ability to be harmonious, dealing with stress will increase naturally. And there is an example that if you want to take an elephant to a market which is full of vegetables, what will you do? How will you walk the elephant? Because wo to usko to kela bhi acha lagta hai, sandra bhi acha lagta hai. So he would want to eat everything. So what would we do? We would just give him a stick to hold while he is walking through the mark. And what will the elephant think? Bola, ye to bahut bada kaam diya mujhe. I have to hold the stick. So whole of his concentration is on holding the stick. And he will walk through the market without any problem. And therefore, ability to concentrate means you are concentrating on one thing, other things don't matter at all. So that is the ability which was generated when you look at the, when you start practicing concentration. And friends, once you are, now this is last 5 minutes in, when you develop the ability to concentrate, you will slowly develop an ability to go into a state of dhyana or meditation. Here is the difference between modern principles and traditional principles. Patanjali says, you can only do concentration and you can go to meditation automatically, but not with your effort. You, aapka dhyan hoga, aap kar nahi sakte. So from dharana, you travel to dhyana where you are completely ekagrah. And friends, it is not an esoteric term. ऐसा नहीं कि बहुत ही बड़ी चीज है. आदमी दिनचर्या में भी ध्यानात्मक स्थिति में रह सकता है. Let us look at some evidence. What has ध्यान led? You know, that is a neurotransmitter from people who are interested in studying the hormones and neurotransmitter. There's a happiness neurotransmitter called GABA. So they studied that how does pranayam and meditation affect GABA. And they saw that people who are practicing, I have quoted the research, the people who are practicing pranayam and meditation, even for a week, noticed an increase in the level of these neurotransmitters. It's called happiness transmitter. So you see what happened. You practiced and scientifically we understand that your ability, because every time you are more harmonious, you are more strengthened to deal with stressful situations. Stressful situation is that position where you are not prepared. It is not a samanvayatma situation. There is another study about how long-term meditation and cortical thickness increases. Meditation increases your cortical. So here we see that there is a physical impact on your neurological health. Increasing of cortical thickness means more gray area. That means, you see, so much of multiplication of good things. These are path-breaking researches which have happened over a period of time in the world. I have quoted the paper and I would encourage people to go and refer to it. So beautiful impacts of yoga. And please remember, I'm again and again saying, yoga is holistic and not only practices of asanas. This is something which we need to be very, very clear about. And then Patanjali says, in the end, there is a complete equanimity, complete harmony, which is the state of samadhi. Is it esoteric? Aisa hai kya are samadhi matlab bahut bada aadmi ho gaya? No. Samadhi means a state of shunyata, where you are not impacted. People can be moving in samadhi. All it means, you are in complete equilibrium. This is the eighth limb of yoga. And what is it? It is a higher state of meditation, which you arrive at. So continue. Now, I am not suggesting that everyone should aim at samadhi. No. But we should know the philosophy well. One may choose to stay at yama, niyam, asana, pranayam. Be happy. Fair enough. Pratyahar. Very, very good. उतना ही करें, अच्छा है, दिनचर्या करें, जीवन तक करते रहें, लेकिन हमको पता होना चाहिए, where the path leads to, it is your decision, how much length you want to walk. This is the experiment, which was done in Kevaladham in 1940s. They studied the difference between samadhi and hypnosis. So friends, very interesting work. I don't have so much of time to elaborate on this research, but essence was, someone said, what is samadhi? It is same as hypnosis. I can hypnotize a person using samadhi. So Swami said, that is not right. Let us experiment. 5 stimulus were given to person who was hypnotized and person who was in samadhi. And they connected various gadgets to see skin galvanic resistance, the heart rate, the response on various other parameters, and they found that person who was in hypnosis or hypnotic condition, jo hypnotic condition mein tha, uska wo stimulus pe reaction hua, physical roop mein nahi tha, but internally there was a change in parameters. Heart rate increased. Jab uske paas thanda pani giraya gaya, skin galvanic resistance soul changes. But person who was in samadhi did not show any such deeper changes. So what that meant was, state of samadhi is reality. State of samadhi is a control over your autonomic nervous system. It is an increased state of your parasympathetic nervous system, which can be achieved by practices of ashtanga. And finally, friends, yoga is not about fad. Yoga is not about get up in the morning, oh, I should buy this and look good and do yoga. Yoga is about making it your lifestyle. योग का मतलब आप अपनी दिनचर्या में कैसे योग का उपयोग कर सकते हैं. यू शुड बी इन अ स्टेट ऑफ हार्मनी थ्रू आउट योर डे, थ्रू आउट योर वीक, थ्रू आउट योर लाइफ, एंड दैट इज द इफेक्ट ऑफ योग. दैट इज व्हाट वी वांट इट टू बी. सो फाइनली द एसेंस ऑफ योगा प्रैक्टिसेस out of all the evidences should result in a better human being, isn't it? In a better human being in present situation or in a situation which is not accordingly conducive, knows how to deal, how to manage. So dealing with ego, yoga helps with it. Asmita, desires, because we always want more of whatever we have. Ability to surrender is induced. Where you cannot control, innate ability to surrender and surrender to that divine. The ability should be there. Equanimity will develop through the practices of yoga. Universal love, that is the essence of sarve bhavantu sukhinaha. Everyone is happy, we are in harmony. Lastly, sincerity is very important. I always say, yoga is not about being serious, it is about being sincere. And sincere means you are able to practice it. 5 minutes kijiye, 10 minutes kijiye. Not necessarily ki aap yoga mat lenge aur 1 ghanta karenge. Lekin 5 minutes kariye, because yoga is an experiential science. Wo aisi goli hai, jab tak aap khayenge nahi, uska aapko pata lagega nahi. So my request to all of you is that all of you should be encouraged to try and practice the aspect of yoga, what we have discussed as the whole and not as a part. So I wish you all the best, and now I will stop sharing my screen here, and I will be open to any questions which are in any form there. Thank you so much, and I hope that there has been some element of clarity which I have been able to get to you. So thank you so much. And now over to you, sir.
Vaibhav sir, unmute your mic.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much for this wonderful session. And we received lots of questions. It's regarding about stress, health. So we'll take the question answer session, sir. So very first question is from the Guhagar, Professor Prasad Bhagwat, Patpanale Mahavidyalay Guhagar. He's saying traditional yoga is a spiritual practice, while contemporary yoga focuses more on fitness. So what is important for us? What's your opinion?
It is actually, it is choice of an individual, but I will say this, that human being is a holistic being. So one needs to have all dimensions completed. So physical, emotional, mental, social, and spiritual. So if you want to be a better human being, then the spiritual dimensions of yoga are very, very essential. Only physical aspect of yoga is very, very small part of the whole.
Okay. Thank you, sir. The next question is from Professor Anjana Verma from Chandrabhan Sharma College. She's asking, sir, we are in lockdown. Knowledge. Her question is, putting that form in official group and looking at that, we are in stress. Why I am lagging behind? So how to overcome with such a pressure?
See, here is I say here is the part of pratyahara. which I spoke of. We think it is compulsory for us to do what the whole world is doing. And therefore, we try to meet the expectation which is not raised by us, but the expectation which has been raised by our peers in the world. And therefore, we are stressed. If someone believes that my job is to do the best quality of teaching, then that person is very clear and he will not strive towards it. The problem arises when you are trying to meet not your expectations, but the expectation of the world. One needs to develop the element of pratyahara, and that is the ability of confidence in one's what we are doing ourselves.
For the next question is Professor Neha Sawan. She has not mentioned her name, college name. She is asking, sir, माझा एक प्रश्न आहे. प्राध्यापक मंडळी सातत्याने उभ्या वर्गासमोर 50 मिनिटे बोलत असतो. घशावर, गळ्यावर, आवाजावर ताण येत असतो. याबाबत कोणता व्यायाम किंवा योग साधना करता येईल? द सेम क्वेश्चन इज फ्रॉम अनदर वन, प्रोफेसर प्रशांत कानडे फ्रॉम विवेकानंद इन्स्टिट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नॉलॉजी चेंबूर. इज आस्किंग, सम टीचर्स आर एक्सपीरियन्सिंग सर्वायल स्पॉन्डायलिसिस अँड प्रॉब्लम्स वोकल कॉर्ड. सो व्हॉट इज योगिक सोल्युशन फॉर इट?
आपल्याला काही अभ्यास असे असतात जे जे प्राध्यापक आहेत ते ऑक्युपेशनल हॅझर्ड, आय से इट्स एन ऑक्युपेशनल हॅझर्ड, यू हॅव टू स्पीक. आपल्याला लेक्चर दौरान बोलणं पडतं फार अँड यू आर स्टँडिंग मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम. सो देर आर सर्टन प्रॅक्टिसेस लाईक देर आर टू थिंग्स विच हॅज टू बी व्हेरी क्लिअर. योग आपण जेव्हा शिकू, आय ऑलवेज रेकमेंड लर्न इट फ्रॉम पर्सनली अ टीचर. फक्त टीव्हीला पाहून योग शिकण्यासारखा नाही आहे, बिकॉज देर इज अ पर्सनल एलिमेंट टू इट. वन्स यू हॅव डन, यू कॅन प्रॅक्टिस युअर सेल्फ. वॉट इज इम्पॉर्टंट फॉर समथिंग लाईक फॉर युअर समन हू स्पीक्स, आपण जास्त वेळ बोलतो तर काही प्रॅक्टिसेस आहेत. फॉर एक्झाम्पल सिंहमुद्रा, यू टेक आउट युअर टंग, एक्झेलेशन, लेरिंग्स, फेरिंग्स, इट इज व्हेरी गुड फॉर युअर वोकल कॉर्ड. सिंहमुद्रा और सिंह आसन इज स्ट्रॉंगली रेकमेंडेड फॉर ऑल द टीचर्स. भ्रामरी प्राणायाम विच इज हमिंग बीचचं साऊंड विच रिलॅक्सेस युअर वोकल कॉर्ड्स अँड द नेझल एरिया, व्हायब्रेशन अच्छा होता आहे, दॅट इज व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट. मेनी अदर, बट आय विल रेकमेंड दीज टू डेफिनेटली. आणि जे लोक जास्त वेळ उभे राहतात त्यांना ताड आसन वरती हात घेऊन खेचायचा, वृक्ष आसन आणि अर्धचक्र आसन, साइड बेंडिंग, दीज पॉस्चर्स आर व्हेरी गुड बिकॉज इट रिड्यूसेस द अमाउंट ऑफ प्रेशर. आणि काय आहे, जर आपण चांगल्यापैकी सवय टाकली तर हे काही पॉस्चर्स आहेत हे आपण शिकवताना पण करू शकतो. उदाहरण तुम्हाला सांगतो, मी एक मीटिंग मध्ये गेलो होतो नीती आयोग मध्ये, आणि तिथे त्यांचे व्हाईस चेअरमॅननी अर्धा तास नंतर ते उभे राहिले आणि सांगितलं मला परवानगी द्या, मी 2 मिनिटं उभं राहून स्ट्रेच करून परत बसणार, मी दर अर्ध तासात ते करतो. सो इट इज हाऊ वी इन्क्लूड दीज प्रॅक्टिसेस इन टू आवर ऑफिशियल सपोर्ट सिस्टम दॅट विल हेल्प अस. लाईक आय से, सकाळी प्रॅक्टिस करणे काही होणार नाही, ड्युरिंग द टाइम दीज थिंग्स आर मिनिमम, रेस्ट ऑल ऑफ कोर्स देर आर मेनी अदर थिंग विच कॅन बी डन.
थँक्यू सर, थँक्यू व्हेरी मच. One more question is from Dr. Nitin Arekan, CHM College, Ullasnagar. It's saying, Vaibhav Subodhjinna, Dhanyavad. What a great presentation, word of wisdom and experience. He mentioned about Sigmund Freud and Patanjali Yoga in early stage of his presentations. A request to him, kindly elaborate on the same.
Nitinji, namaste. So, he's a good friend. Lot of concepts of more of Jung, lot of concepts of Patanjali are borrowed by Carl Jung in his principles of psychology and psychoanalysis. Though the fact is, he recognizes the existence, but he does not acknowledge Patanjali Yoga Sutras as the source of his information. So, the principles of Kleshas, for example, have been dealt with Carl Jung also. Now, Carl Jung was a student of Freud, and Freud has elaborated on the theory of fear and other desires which modulate the behavioral aspect of the personality. So, of course, we can have personal elaborate discussion, but the whole interconnection is that a lot of the philosophy which was espoused by these people have their bearings coming from Patanjali's Yoga Sutras, which have not been acknowledged, but they are apparent.
Yes. So the next question is from Dr. Meenakshi Iyer Ganopadhyay from Nalanda Nritya Kala Mahavidyalaya, Mumbai. Question is, it is said that expectations lead to sorrows, but as a teacher, we have and must have expectations from our students. So how to tackle this situation and remain stress-free?
This is actually very interesting. You know, there is one element which we discussed, and that is element of, you know, expectation can be equated with the raga, which we have discussed in Yamas. One of the kleshas, raga is attachment. Expectation is an attachment to positive flow of events, isn't it? What I always say personally, it is a good idea to have expectation, it is good idea to be attached, but it is not a good idea that your happiness is dependent on that attachment or achievement. Because if you are dependent on it, the moment it is not achieved, you will be miserable. So while your expectation should be high, you should be ready that if it is not achieved, your equilibrium is still maintained. And that will come through the practices of yoga.
Yes. Thank you, sir. Sir, next two questions are related to our work. Our health, the teachers are asking. One is from Vishal Singh, Sri Krishna Khamkarpal. He is asking, sir, we teachers having lot of paper checking work, a teacher having backbone pain, so which type of yoga we can do for relaxation? The second question is also the same from Dr. Mukta Pote from SK Somaya College, Mumbai. Actually, I like very much to write different study material for students and other things, but I am suffering writing cramps problem and simultaneously doing also yoga few asana. So please suggest how to solve this problem by yoga.
Two things I will suggest, that instead of me demonstrating, you should go to YouTube and you should type Kaivalya Dham. आम्ही भरपूर वीडियोज अपलोड केलेले आहेत तिथे प्रॅक्टिसचे, कारण दे आर रिलेटेड अँड दे आर सबस्टेन्शिएटेड बाय सायंटिफिक एव्हिडन्स. सो फॉर एक्झाम्पल, देर इज अ होल सिरीज बाय डॉक्टर शरद भालेकर ऑन योग फॉर मॅनेजिंग बॅक हेल्थ. ते एकदा तुम्ही पाहून घ्या. सेकंडली, देर इज अ रिसेंट सिरीज विच इज गोईंग ऑन विथ मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ आयुष. And though this is for geriatric population, ithe kahi ke practices hai. For example, for your hands, you know, some simple practices like imagining holding of the ball like this and pressing your fingers together. And Siya Mudra madhe stretching of the fingers, rotation of your wrists through the wall. Ashe bharpur practices ami te YouTube channel madhe dakhavlele ahe. So there is no need to reinvent the wheel. And you can follow that, and simple practices you should adopt. One practical advice I have, whatever you are doing continuously, please take a break. Asa maza je ata tumhi aikla asel, it is 5 o'clock, mi aplya computer madhe ek tasacha alarm takla, ek tasa nantar I will get up, do my stretches, do my bends, and then sit. Tar kahi savay ashi taka that you take a break in your continuous work and do those certain practices that should form part of your life, and that is the way you are able to gain.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. We are taking last two questions. Many questions, sir, are received. Yes, please.
Sir, one question I would like to take in between. Since Subodhji is a member of UGC and a lot of connections at Ayush Ministry, so is it possible to take yoga in the syllabus, and you know, so that that can be practiced right in the beginning of the class or the beginning of the session? So is there any way to take it through UGC or through universities so that that can become a practice?
Thanks, Subhash. I have been, yes, it is true, I have been part of the committee of UGC. And then I realized one very important fact, because we made the draft module and syllabus for the BSc yoga courses from on behalf of the UGC. And after everything which is done in UGC, they say, but the universities are autonomous and they will have to decide what to do. We can only recommend. So I think it's a, see, the syllabus is already there, but a practical module for these practices for teachers. My recommendation is, if your organization can come forward, then we should be able to develop specific modules for occupational hazard for teachers. And this can be practiced by teachers for their well-being.
One more thing I would like to ask, that is, since Kabiladham Yoga Institute is more into research, so if you could tell us about some teachers program which Kabiladham is organizing, and some you know, facilities like 14 days special leave for the teachers to come there and do a yoga certificate course. So I think if you could elaborate on that, the teachers community will get a benefit out of it.
With your question, I just got an idea that what we can do, we can launch a special certificate program for teachers, which will be a hybrid program. Theoretical part, teachers can do online. And for the practice-oriented part, we will organize an intensive program at various Kabiladham centers like Lonavala and Mumbai or wherever, so that teachers are able to complete the certification program, which is actually has a lot of credence and recognized by various authorities like the YCB under Ministry of Ayush, because we are declared as the leading yoga institution. So something of this can be taken forward. We design something and definitely mail it to you for further certification.
Yeah, sure, sir. Please send that proposal, because I am, as a management council member, I can suggest the university to think on it.
Definitely.
Yes, sir.
I would love to do that.
Yeah, sir. Only last question, sir, I'm taking, it's related to time. That's why the Dr. Manjusha Cheda from SPN Doshi Women's College in Mumbai. Hello, sir. I have questions. A woman like us working since morning 5 a.m. to 4 p.m. household and college continuously. What is the ideal time for them to do yoga kriya? What are handling double stresses?
So first is, I have a lot of respect for women, because they work, I think, much, much harder than men. And I think in such situations, the best thing to do, like I suggested, that we need to inculcate these practices into our working schedule. Train madhe jatanna apan kay karu shakto, college madhe bastanna kay karu shakto, ubha rahatanna kay karu shakto, because taking out half an hour, 1 hour may not be possible. फक्त घराच्या बाहेर पडताना तुम्ही जर 5 मिनिटांसाठी 10 मिनिटांसाठी 2 आसन आणि प्राणायाम केले, इट विल गिव्ह यू अ गुड स्टार्ट, अँड देन इन्क्लूड दिस वेर एव्हर पॉसिबल. दॅट इज द ओनली वे यू विल बी एबल टू इन्कल्केट इट, बिकॉज दॅट इज अ प्रॅक्टिकल डिफिकल्टी विच वी फेस.
ओके सर, थँक्यू.
आय हॅव रिसीव्ड वन क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम गोवा सर. ही इज आस्किंग अबाउट व्हॉट सिंपल थिंग विच अ टीचर कॅन डू. If at all any stress, like sir had given the example that if he enters into the class principal's cabin and if he shouts, then that automatically gets converted to next. So what is the best way, you know, to stop that anger or that anxiety there itself, and it should not pass on to the further students?
Practice of breath control is the best thing. Zar apan, if we have learned Anulom Vilom Pranayam or deep breathing, if we can just come out, devote 2-3 minutes or 5 minutes to that practice, immediately, scientifically, the parasympathetic activity will increase. It will give a relaxative stimulus to your ANS, and you will be more relaxed than what you were 5 minutes before. So that is something which one needs to practice offhand, which can be incorporated at one's own will.
Sir, there is a question from Mr. Nair from Karnataka. He is asking how to perform the yoga if climatic conditions are different.
Well, like I said, it is very difficult to control the external environment all the time. So the only way I suggest is that if it is, it depends what is, like if it is very cold, very hot, very polluted. But if you are living in that area, all we can do is wherever we are, try to create the best possible environment, which is possible.
Okay, thank you, sir. I think you have given elaborated answers to all the questions, and it was a wonderful session. Vaibhav sir, any questions are there still?
Lots of questions are there, but we are running out of time, so we stop here. So many teachers are asking these PPTs, this presentation PPTs. If it is possible, please give your email ID. Otherwise, our email ID is on screen.
Yeah, I will send it to you all. Definitely, I will send a PDF file so all of us you can distribute it.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. And last but not least, I request Professor Athavale, please give vote of thanks.
Sir, thank you very much. Initially, I think to introduce you, there was some connection error and I couldn't make it. But really, really, it was a wonderful session. And I think all those teachers who are participating would definitely get some good practices which they can perform and to stop the anxiety at that point of time. You have made a mention of Swami Kavalananda Ji. And the since I have got the opportunity to visit Kaivalya Yoga Dham on number of occasions, we have started working when Principal Panjwani was there at CHM College. And I think since then, I have a very close association with Kaivalya Dham, and even that is maintained today. I think the what Subodh sir have explained about pranayam and the scientific way of how to perform it, I think that is a unique one and which you could get only at Kaivalya Yoga Dham, Lonavala. As he said, being on a member of the UGC, definitely if he'll prepare a capsule of a course where teachers can be benefited, definitely number of teachers would like to come forward and perform this yoga so that they can become healthy. And the teachers who are teaching to the generations, students, I think they will pass on to them. And definitely it will help to, reduce the anxiety and reduce that kind of thing from the students as well. I thank you very much, Subodh sir, for taking out time for all of us, all the teachers community. Let me tell you that today we are on parthlive.com. We are going live on it. And also we have on YouTube. So a lot of questions have come there as well. But I think it is very difficult to ask as the limitation of the time. I thank Parth Network Private Limited, who had made yesterday when I was talking, they said it is very difficult because today all of us have decided to take a break, but then they have made it possible, and because of whom we could reach to not less than 2000 teachers at a time through YouTube and through parthlive.com. I take this opportunity to thank all the teachers community who have taken a lot of efforts to join this. All of them were calling me that what is the link, where are we should get. That also creates anxiety. Since I was not picking up the phone, the anxiety was developing. And then I was sending them messages. So I think in between, I was losing my voice connectivity. Anyway, but it was a wonderful session, sir. Thank you very much. And thank you for devoting time and giving such a wonderful session to all our teachers community. Thank you very much.
My pleasure. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Stop the live streaming, please.